close to one.
So, forget the plan or just don't care?
Fuck the plan. I'm going in.
That is both fucking reckless and fucking stupid. I love it. Enough charges have been set. Ready? PTSD for everyone. Hotel's all yours, Danny. Get in there, and don't come out without Castillo's head.
In the clear.
Thank you.
There was no blockade. There were no hands around our port. The Yankees drink our rum, dance with our welcome the world with open arms. We are only rich. The three killers were waiting. And so I was forced to watch the Starlight's turn. Watch me, Papa, murdered by the Terrorista Revolution, 1967. For 50 years, this revolution caused and left us with ghosts. I am haunted by the lessons me, Papa, taught me as a child. The dreams he had for me. My family, my country. Before he was murdered, he used to tell me the dream he had.
Hey, Danny.
That was the envy of the
world. What are you talking about?
She's exploring
that
will
be passed down for few generations.
He's still giving that stupid speech.
Now, I have the same dreams for my own son. I finally understand what he meant. You elected me to rebuild Tararice. And now you, my true Yaras, are delivering on that vision. The draft to rebuild Tararice is a great success. We are producing a cancer treatment the world is desperate for. The demand for Viviro has never been higher. We have already begun to the future. We have found a path to paradise. And yet once again, another so-called revolution. Another group of terrorists. Another pack of fake mutants. Is nothing but a cancer from within who want to burn everything built on the ground. But now, the stakes are much higher. For the fake Yarans are not just a threat to me or you. They are a threat to Yara's very survival. When you elected me, you elected the truth. And the truth is simple. There are no second chances. Yara must produce Viviro, and only Viviro. More Viviro than ever before. And if we allow these terrorists to distract us, there's only one. Failure. 1967. And then, for over 50 years, this revolution cost us our wealth, our pride, our hope, and left us with ghosts. I am haunted by the lessons mi papa taught me as a child. The dreams he had for me, my family. Same dreams from my own son, Diego. I finally understand what he meant.
To catch that elevator.
My true Yarens, today marks over 100 years of independence for our country. It marks a day Yara stood together with one voice and demanded freedom from its Spanish oppressors. It was a day of bloodshed, of revolution. A revolution that proclaimed to our colonizers, we are not your servants, we are not your toys, we are Yara.
This got the key for the penthouse.
Gave us our freedom, but it also gave us something else. Something we are afraid to admit. It gave us an addiction to chaos. The word
revolution became an excuse for some Yarns to act on their wildest impulses, to indulge their selfish desires, to embrace chaos. Me papa called them fake Yarns. I am old enough to remember a Yara before 1967. Back then, I was not just the son of El Presidente. I was a child in love with the Yara me papa had built. There was no blockade. There were no hands around our throats. We're begging to come to our island, drink our rum, dance with our women. Me papa welcomed the world with open arms. We were not only rich, we had soul. But the fake Yarns were waiting. And so I was forced to watch me papa's paradise burn. To watch me papa murdered by the terrorista revolution in 1967. And then, for over 50 years, this revolution cost us our wealth. Before he was murdered, he used to tell me of a dream he had.